Welcome to Pokemon Freak Advance everyone, and in this video I am going to talk about some Pokemon games that you might have never played before. Now I won't be telling any main series games obviously, but we'll be telling about some rare Pokemon spin-offs. So let's start the video. Now before we start this video, I want to tell that if you have played any of these games before seeing the video, then please comment down below and let's start. The first game is Pokemon Bat Trio. It was released in November 21st, 2007, but the bad thing about it was that it was an arcade game and was only released in Japan. Pokemon Bat Trio is a game like Pokemon Stadium, but with 3 Pokemon versus 3 Pokemon, and that is what makes its name Battle and Trio Pokemon Bat Trio. And yes, this was the first time triple battles was introduced, not in Black and White or Black and White 2. The game was developed by Takara Tomy and AQ Interactive, and the game has 19 types, but instead of this modern fairy type, there is the full blade type and the 11 blade type. There's a lot more information about the game. I will put the Bulbapedia link for this game and all the other games in the description below. The second game is Pokemon Catch the Numbers. It is an educational game released in July 23, 2002 and was only released in Japan. There are mini games with math in it, and there is voice acting with anime characters from the Pokemon anime. Yes, there was voice acting in a Pokemon game in the year 2002, but not in the year 2021, and the game sounds very much fun and looks good for the year 2002. Now the third game is not some arcade or console game, but a mobile game, and yes, available only in Japan. The game is called Pokemate and was released on December 31st, 2006. It was developed by Square Enix and was like a communication app but with Pokemon. The app was completely free, but a monthly subscription of 210 yen or $1.84 was required for more Pokeballs or former service edition. The service was discontinued in January 2008, and the game sounds very much fun except for the paid part, and the game had like a Pokemon camp like in Pokemon Sword and Shield, but with less features and with less graphics because it was like 2006, and the game is likely to have a US release at some point according to Cerebi, but I think the Pokemon company just forgot about the game like they forgot Pokemon Sleep. Now let's get to the game that was although released worldwide and recently, and by recently I mean like 2 years ago, or yeah, 2 years ago, and that game is known as Pokemon Medallion Battle. The game had 7 types, that is colorless, grass, fire, water, lightning, fighting and psychic. The platform of the game was Facebook, and it was like one of those mini games in it, and it was released on December 23rd, 2019, so technically 2 years ago, and it is available in 5 languages: English, Malaysian, Indonesian, Thai and traditional Chinese. The last time I checked, the game has like 33,370 likes, and it looks like a good game. And it's almost like a standard Pokemon game, but it focuses more on Pokemon gyms and your teams, and that's what it has, making your own teams and battling with other Pokemon in the gyms. And I played the game for like 1 minute and it looked very good, and it's like the Pokemon online trading card game, and the game has bag, Pokedex, shop, mail and battle menus, and it's a very fun game, and like 200,000 people played. Now the fifth game is Pokemon Hide and Seek. Pokemon Seek and Find, and it was a part of 3 games for the Pokemon's 10th year anniversary. It is a simple game where a player has to follow cues to find one Pokemon among a group of Pokemon. The player can play as Ash or Mei and must find the 10 Pokemon directed to win. The first level has no time limit, but the next two have about 7 minutes and 2 minutes respectively. It would be a very good game if it was to be remade and if the game was continuously updated. The sixth game is Pokemon Pokeball Launcher, and is another game that was made for Pokemon's 10th year anniversary. It was a flash based computer game. For the 10th year anniversary of Pokemon though, there were 3 games made, as I told before, that was Pokemon Seek and Find, Pokemon Pokeball Launcher and Pokemon Team Rocket Blast Off, but I won't be talking about Pokemon Team Rocket Blast Off because it's just like telling the same type of game. The game is a very simple game where the player throws Pokeballs to catch the Pokemon. Like Pokemon Seek and Find, the player controls as either Ash or Mei, and the player has a limited amount of time and Pokeballs with which the player has to catch enough Pokeballs. Pokemon to win. The first level has 2 minutes, the second level has 2 minutes, and the last level has 1 minute. So it gets tougher and tougher. And it only has 3 levels. The game has like 20 Pokemon. It is very fun to play. I did not play it. I don't know how can I play it now, but yeah, it's very fun to play. Like, it's like Pokemon Snap, but not that much advanced and only 20 Pokemon. Now the next game is Pikachu DS Tech Demo, and it was a tech demo for the Nintendo DS that was available at E3 into the year 2004, and it was just to show everyone how cool the DS was. See the stylus, the touch screen, double touch screen, so cool. And the game was never made available public. And I think many people had fun playing the game, and it involves playing with 3D model of Pikachu at a location called Pokemon Park. It is basically playing with the virtual Pikachu. Now the final and the 8th game is the Guinness World Record for the longest Pokemon game's name, that is Intellectual Training Drill Pokemon Diamond and Pearl Letter and Number Intelligence Game. And I'm telling you, this is the longest name for a Pokemon game. The game is just an educational game like Pokemon Catch the Numbers, and is based on the Pokemon series Diamond and Pearl, and I don't know much about it. There was nothing in Biopedia, and I think it's a game made only in Japan because there was nothing English related to it, but I don't know much information about the game. Now thanks for seeing this video, everyone. I think I can make a part 2 and a part 3 for this video. Not sure about the part 3, but yeah, there it's very tough to find games that are very rare. And if you want me to continue this series, please like, subscribe, comment down below. Commenting will help more though. And wait for me, and yeah, wait for the next video. Bye guys.